terrific quarterback who won the Super Bowl this year. Unfortunately, he suffered a heartbreaking loss yesterday when the Dallas Cowboys lost to Miami Dolphins. It was just in the closing seconds of a very snowy, boy, what a slippery game. In case you miss it, look at the conditions if you say you know what we're talking about. Take a look here. Please welcome Troy Aikman. Let me ask you an honest question. Were you almost going to cancel today?
Well, I wasn't, but once I got here and found out that everybody was surprised that I showed up, I would have canceled.
No, but that's classy. But I mean, sometimes when, especially when something is this, I mean, devastating, we just kind of go, oh man, it's just something that could have been avoided.
It was a tough loss, and I think we've all been involved in losses where they were disappointing and heartbreaking. They came down at the end, but none of us had ever been involved in a game where we were celebrating, thinking we had won, and then only to have it taken away from us, and then they kicked the field goal to win, and it was devastating.
Can we explain to people, because I was explaining to folks, some friends of mine who don't quite follow the game, actually, here about, okay, the game is over. The game is, well, it's closing seconds. Miami kicks a field goal. Doesn't go. Gets deflected. Right. Now, if the ball had landed on the ground and nobody touched it, you guys would have won the game.
Right. Okay. And in fact, I didn't even know what happened until I got into the locker room after the ball game and was talking to some of the guys. And that's when I found out that, yeah, if nobody goes and gets it, then we win the ball game.
Dead ball.
Leon saw all the Dolphin players running for the ball, and so he took off running for it, thinking, I guess, that if they recovered it, it would be their ball. He touched it, and then they did get it and got another chance.
They touched it. And so just by touching it, it's the same as if you had picked it up and fumbled it, right, and recovered.
Right.
So, and then they kicked. Oh, man, that's a killer.
That's poor Leon.
It's got to be a rough day for him. I mean,
Leon.
They must have taken him out of there in a laundry truck, hiding under all that. I mean,
and Leon is a very dear friend of mine, but I was reading the Dallas papers on the way in on the plane this afternoon, and they said, well, you got to, the one good thing about Leon is he knows when to do it. You know, the two most heavily watched ball games,
yeah,
the Super Bowl and then the Thanksgiving ball game, and it's been tough for him.
Did you see in the paper? Did you read it off the wanted poster? I'm confused.
Then on top of it, he's got to come here, and I'm calling him Todd Acorn. So,
yeah,
I mean,
that's right. Yeah, it's a tough
day.
It has been a very tough weekend.
Have you ever played in that? I mean, it looked like Santa's elves watching the game. I mean, have you ever played in that much snow? Is that the worst?
That was the worst I'd ever played in, and especially to have that kind of weather in Dallas, because
yeah,
it's extremely unusual for us to have that kind of snow and sleet and those conditions.
Now, you pulled a hamstring. How long ago?
I pulled it 3 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And I pulled it against the Giants. In fact, it was still a little bit tender in the ball game yesterday, but yet I was able to still go out and play.
Now, but that's an injury that'll, I mean, that stays with you for months and months, doesn't it, when you...
Well, they say it can take 2 months to heal. You know, I came back after really 2 weeks and played in this last ball game. Joe Montana came back after 2 weeks and re-aggravated, and now he's still missing time. And I've been real fortunate that nothing happened to me in yesterday's game.
Yeah, yeah. How about the Super Bowl? What contender? What do you think? Where are you?
Well, I like our chances. I think that we're still a very good football team. I think San Francisco has come on strong again right now. We got some. Do we have any Dallas fans here tonight? But we're going to have to pick it up. We've had two devastating losses over the last two ball games, and we've got five to go, and there's still a lot of football left to be played,
yeah,
and we're going to have
yeah
to pick it up a little.
Well, I imagine something like that is so demoralizing. It does get your spirits down, doesn't it? Like you say, because you're celebrating, and then what happened?
Well, it was tough. You know, again, we expected to win. To be 8-2 right now, or 8-3 as opposed to 7-4 is a big difference.
Yeah, yeah. But I know also you're a big country music fan, and you sing. I heard that you're singing.
I don't sing. No.
Go sing.
I don't sing, Jay.
You mean I've got this wrong? You don't sing?
Mm-mm.
You know, I'm in the store and I see this CD. Can you get a shot of this here? This is like a bad This Is Your Life, isn't it? Here, look at that triangle. Look at that. But you sing on this fine, fine CD.
Uh-huh. And,
you know, I picked this up today.
Well, I have to explain the story here. You know, last year when I was on after the Super Bowl, you asked me if I sang. I guess you were under the impression that I was a singer. And,
yeah.
And I had never sang in my life, with the exception of in the shower, you know, like everyone does. And then these people came up to me, and Jay Novacek, who plays for us, and Walt Garrison and Randy White, and asked us if we'd be interested in singing a song and for this album, and kind of having a takeoff from the Super Bowl success. And I originally said no,
mm-hmm.
and then decided to go ahead and do it. And I thought it'd be fun, and I didn't take myself seriously. And I, as you know, if you've heard it,
I think people should get a chance to hear a little of the song.
I mean, just, you know, because I think.
Well, let me just lead into this, just so nobody has any false expectations. One of the radio stations there in Dallas, after it came out, because what happened was they released my song first, so all these people thought that I was actually doing an album of my own.
Right.
When they didn't realize that it was in fun. And so I took a beating publicly on this thing, and one of the DJs said that I had forgot to take my mouthpiece out before I recorded it.
Well, you know, I only bring this up because you were making fun of Terry Bradshaw. Remember you were saying Terry Bradshaw, what did he say, better commentator than he is singer or something like that. Well, here, let people hear, because some people might think you're a fine singer. They might think maybe the guy is being modest.
Well, they might if we don't play it.
No, let's hear. Can we hear just a little bit of Troy singing?
Here down 66, this old pickup truck and me. Your memory, thinking about how two young
kids. It gets better.
Okay, thanks. That's enough. Tommy, look at Tommy, two thumbs up.
Yeah.
Two thumbs up. There you go. Maybe you could throw a football later for him too. So the critics are pretty harsh on the tune.
They were until they understood exactly. You know, why we did it. And, you know, the proceeds that I get from it, which
yeah.
I'm not even sure if there are any, because I have not received, I haven't received anything from it, are going to my foundation.
Oh, well, that's good. I mean, that's yeah. all good. I mean, obviously it's in fun. And you mean
sure.
people thought you being serious, just being silly.
Well, we took it as seriously as we could with the realization of our own limitations.
Yeah, so. Yeah. No, but it's fun to listen. Because when I, you know.
I appreciate you playing it for
when
us.
When I hear this in the car and then I sing, I go, hey, I'm pretty good. That's the idea, I think. No.
Well, after when I did this, they took me. See, I made it. I only let one person in the studio when I did it, and that was the one controlling the knobs. No one else I would even let in there. And
so
when I got done, he says, "Well, come listen to it," you know. So I listened to it, and he says, "That's pretty good." I said, "You know, hey, Doc was his name." I said, "Hey, Doc. You know, I've got friends that are in the country industry, and I've heard their rough versions, and theirs is pretty good. This is horrible." So it was even worse than what that sounded like, if you can believe it.
Well, I think you're a great sport, and it's all for charity, and it's a good cause. And hey, thanks for coming. I know how tough it is, man, after something like yesterday, but you're the greatest.
Thank you.
You're just the greatest.
Thank you. Thank you.